Hey, boys! Hey,
girl! I gotta make a crawfish bisque for Miss JB's birthday. That's what she wanted. And I've got some frozen crawfish tail meat ready to go. 3 pounds, it's $9.99 a pound right now. And I'm gonna start off with a microwave roux for the actual bisque. And we'll go from there. Got the flour measured out in a cup. Cup of flour, half a cup of oil. And I want to add some butter in it after. You can't put butter in a microwave roux. So add some to it after the fact. 5 minutes on high, then you'll see. Now we got our roux ready from the microwave. Go ahead and pour it in here. And don't get none on you. Like I already told y'all, don't do it. You're about to be pissed off with yourself. One cup of flour, about 3/4 cups of oil. It may cool down a little bit, so I'm gonna bring it back up to temperature. And it's a little bit grainy looking, that's all right. The grain fitting to go away. You gotta stir this while it's on that fire. It'll burn. You don't want it to burn. I can see that size fire on that big pot.
Don't stop stirring. Don't you understand?
Don't stop. I'm gonna crank the heat up on it. We're fitting to cool it down big time. I got an onion, a nice size onion, a nice size bell pepper, and a couple of celery hearts, sticks, pieces apart. They all in here. Now they all in the roux. All of y'all in the roux. We're gonna cook these in that roux. Now you don't have to stir quite as often now. You still gotta stir. I'm also gonna put some butter in here. See down there? Nice little knob of butter going in there. You could use crawfish fat, but I ain't got that, Jack. Butter works just fine. We'll cook this for about 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, I'm gonna put up a whole bunch. It's a whole bunch of green onion. You know, a bunch about that big around. The whole package. Stir them in there. This is a homemade Trinity. We're also gonna get some garlic in there. Gonna make it that many a tea. That cook for another minute. I'll go ahead and press in. Got 5 toes of garlic, about that size. You can chop them and put them in there, but I'm gonna press them in there. And don't screw up and burn this. Then you have to start all over again. You'd be pissed off to the highest level of pissivity. Here's some instant dyed stock. Come out of my tap. Stir that in here. It's gonna thicken up some. That was about 3 cups. We're gonna need another 2 cup. We're gonna let this cook for a while and simmer down. Cook the vegetables. I gotta get some parsley in here too. So let me get that chopped up. I'm gonna start out with a good tablespoon of salt. Some pepper as soon as I find it. Some pepper. Probably good that much. Stir this in and let this simmer for about an hour. Meanwhile, you can go and drink beer. There's a roux that I made in the oven. Just a thin layer of flour on a baking sheet at 350 for about 20-25 minutes till it change color like that. We're gonna use that for crawfish balls. Think boudin balls, but made with crawfish tail meat. About the same thing, actually. Except we're not gonna fry them, we're gonna bake them because it's easier. I got a bunch to make. Traditionally in crawfish bisque, you would take the thorax, which is the head part of the crawfish, clean it, paint it a butt. I mean, big paint it a butt. And you stuff the breading crawfish mixture back in it that we're gonna make here in a little bit. She's easy to make balls, like meatballs, except crawfish meatballs. Yum. Got some curly parsley in my pizza cutter. And I'm just kind of whacking it up. Go back and forth and have a good time. Makes it easy. Gotta go in the bisque. Wash this first, get the big stems out. Sticks and seeds and shit, you don't want to eat that. Okay, I got some more Trinity chop up in here. And we're fitting to go brown this. And it's rough chop because we're going to process this in the food processor for the crawfish heads. The stuff the heads with, yeah. I got some melted butter. That oven made roux. I'll put that in there and incorporate this. Seeing that? It's already cooked. All I want to do is warm it through, and I'm going to put these vegetables in there. It looks warm through to me. How about you? Yep, with the butter, yum. See all that foaming? If you would try that in the microwave with butter, because butter does have some water in it, it'll foam over. Make a big mess. Hate that when that happens. Go on and pour this in there. You'll attempt to get it in the pot. Like that. With the parsley hole, like I said, we're gonna put it in the food processor once we cool it off. We do want to pre-cook this, all right? salt.
And pepper.
And this is going to get a second cook in a little bit. We ain't ready for that yet, though. Let's go ahead and add our rough chopped garlic. You see how it's starting to stick? Don't let that happen. Tighten up, JB. This is going in the food processor. I already told y'all that. Let's put some water in there. Oh, a dyed water, yeah. Stock. That'll release that stuckness on the bottom. And put it in cold. Don't put no hot water in here. You'd have to throw this away and start over. So here's our cooled roux mixture. We're gonna put it into a food processor. Give it a couple of pulses. We're gonna get some moat in just a bit. This is 1 pound. I'm going to put 2 pounds of this tail meat in there. And they're not fully cooked. They've been steamed but peeled by hand. So I like to rinse them because I don't know whose hands peeled them. And we'll finish cooking them. I'll show y'all how. Two pounds are going in here total. I want y'all to keep in mind that if you had your own crawfish boil and you peeled your own crawfish with your hands, you would know what's up. Somebody else peeled these and they get paid about an hour to do it. If they can do X amount of pounds in this many hours, they get this much money. I don't know what the ratio is, but and I know by rinsing them, we're getting rid of some of the fat that was on them. That's why I added butter. Oh, and look, I want to thank Mark for this Peps. Thanks, Mark. Pulse. And we'll finish assembling these balls. Smells good. Let's get it all out and put it in here. And we're going to continue to build on this. Fruit. Oh, don't trust that. Do not trust that. Put it in something else in case that cackle fruit hatches. You don't want to ruin $20 worth of crawfish meat. Cackle fruit good. Okay, put him in there. bust it up. We're gonna get about, we're gonna get some breadcrumbs in here till we can work it and form some little meatballs. We'll start with 1 cup. Just plain breadcrumbs. Mix this all around until you get something that you can work in the balls. And 1 cup looked pretty damn close. I'm gonna take one little sample and nuke it and check it for seasoning. Because the egg ain't cooked and the crawfish ain't fully cooked. Now, I ain't eating no damn sushi crawfish, I'm sorry. It's missing some Cajun seasoning, big time. So we're gonna add some slap boudreaux. And it needs a lot more salt. And some pepper. Stir. And once you got your mixture like you want it, you can drop out some little meatballs on a lightly greased baking sheet. Grease it with butter too. Trust me. They ain't gotta be perfect. Put them down there. Try to get them all about the same size though. And they're not going to expand like a biscuit. So, now you know. So if you got any mixture left, you can just go put it up in the meat, in the gravy. See? We always have this with rice and some French bread.
Yum.
All your vegetables are in there. So, yum.
Oh yeah, baby.
I forgot. You gotta put 1 pound in here too. Now, stir that around. And this will be ready shortly. And you see the fat coming off from the butter? Don't take that off. You want that. Yum. It's good for you. Dip your bread in there. Get you some rice. And get you some of this stuff here. And we need something better than this to serve with. I can tell you that right now. So, thank you. So let's get us some of this. Look at that crawfish tail hanging on that damn thing. Oh, yum. Get you some of that bisque. And here's them, it magically appeared with the help of JP. Get you one of them right on top. Everybody can only have two. You get more than two. You get more than two, then you'll be shot. Okay, so got that bisque with crawfish patties. Yum. Stuff this with some butter. The bread, it's been warmed in the oven. Just dunk some butter up in the well. See, like that?
That's bad for you.
Yeah, don't eat that.
Francois French bread from Poupard Bakery in Lafayette, Louisiana. Good stuff. Notice on this package, it says farm raised. If they'd be wild caught, it'd be checked. Or it'd mixed, it'd be checked. And farm raised are good. Wild caught's even better, but these were great. Making these balls or patties is easier than stuffing the thorax of the head, because after they've been stuffed and cooked, then you got to dig the stuffing back out while they're hot, and they burn your little fingers. This way you can just eat. Yum. This is great. Look at JP's plate. Well, he piling on. JP, you can't get no more on that plate, boy. There's my little sample. That's when I knew I needed to add more salt after I nuked it, and the dogs loved it. Here's a couple out-of-focus shots. And I was in the store, and I took a shot with my cell phone the other day of a king cake display. And I figured I'd give y'all a little history lesson about the king cake and what it's about coming up next. Enjoy.